localwebradio.fm, your trusted voices on the Semiahmoo Peninsula.
Are you dealing with a health issue you would love to resolve? Would you like to restore yourself to be healthier and more invigorated? There is help. Welcome to the Natural Therapy Show with Dr. Tim Brown, architect and creator of Ocean Park Natural Therapies. Now, here's your host.
Eva Marienchild here, and yes, I am your host. I am here with Dr. Tim Brown, chiropractor and ND, and owner of Ocean Park Natural Therapies, and creator of Solving Your Health Puzzle with Integrated Medicine. Today, Dr. Brown will be discussing pain, injury, and trauma, and what we have learned about it. Now, before Dr. Brown joins us, just a little reminder that if you in the audience have any questions or you require assistance, you can reach Dr. Brown's office at 604-538-3017. Or you can visit the staff online at www.oceanparkhealth.com. All right. And Dr. Brown, welcome to the call.
Good day to you as well.
Thank you. It's nice to hear your voice again. Let's go. What can you tell us about pain, injury, and trauma?
Well, the first thing is that we know all cellular life is about moving towards what's good for us or moving away from what's threatening, harmful, or what we don't like. So pain, injury, and trauma become imprints as part of our human long-term survival, memory, and adaptation systems. In other words, what we learn from our life lessons. If you survive, you learn not to do that again. Or if you get a big thrill from doing something and you like it, when you release these dopamine and endorphins into your system, you basically say, let's do that again. So furthermore, these behaviors are especially prevalent in the child or teenage brain, where the prefrontal cortex or the executive adult long-term planning function has not yet developed fully. And so we know kids, and especially teenagers, try things to test out the environment, and they try to find the limits of what's safe or not safe. And, you know, this risk-taking kind of behavior is especially prevalent in the teenage brain, and it's more dangerous because they're transitioning from a world of the safety of the childhood into sort of the adult level of activities with cars and motorcycles and, you know, drugs and all the things. And they don't always have the constraints, or let's say they're trying to find where the edges are. And, of course, then you find what's over the edge. And sometimes the consequences are significant.
So in those cases, the adrenaline takes over.
Well, it's more than just adrenaline. It's the classic example when you ask somebody why they did it. It's kind of like it seemed like a good idea at the time.
So, and it seemed like I would survive.
Well, I didn't even think about that. I thought it would be fun. Mm. Okay. And you see some of these things on YouTube and stuff like that. And the fact that people survive, they get the thrill and the imprint. But of course, the downside is, you know, and I see it sometimes in my practice where a teenager or a child has now had a significant brain injury. Or they've had a spinal injury and they're paralyzed, and you know, things like that. So, that's the sad part of it.
Right. Yeah. Kids with their bikes too, the scooter bikes. They have to be careful. Lots of accidents in the news about that. Dr. Brown, can you tell us more about this long-term survival memory system?
Yes. I've been interested in studying brain function and neurology for many years. And so what we know is that in reptiles, this long-term kind of survival memory system is arranged around survival issues of food, territory, and reproduction. And reptiles essentially lay or hatch their eggs, and then they kind of abandon their young to their own devices, which their functioning is mostly built on instincts and habits. So with a reptile, like the, I think it's a Komodo dragons on the one of the islands out in the Pacific there, if you get into their territory and they see you as a threat, then, of course, they come and attack you. And, you know, with things like snakes and things, they lay their eggs and then they all hatch and run off into the environment. Or with turtles, you know, they hatch and run off into the ocean or somewhere like that. But this totally changes when you start dealing with mammals and some of the other species like birds. With mammals, there's the added feature of bonding. And I describe bonding as physical closeness with emotional openness, so that you can take in and learn behaviors from those that you bond with, either as an individual or a group, quotes, family. So this bonding is needed for protection and for learnings that can be passed on as a wisdom from the elders or the group regarding survival and how to function in the group.
So I would assume, because of intelligent evolution, the human system has developed some sort of imprint capacity?
Yes. The what happens is we imprint information related to the four primary events. And I'm going to say they're pain, abandonment, trauma, and anything that has strong emotional content. And the last thing that we store then is anything that resembles the first four.
Hmm. Could you clarify that a bit? What could you give us some examples of what you mean?
Yes. Let's look at pain. If you're young and you touch something that shocks or pricks you, it hurts. You create a one-time learning not to do that again because it's unpleasant and could harm you. So if a child puts a finger in like a light electric socket or something, they're going to have a one-time learning not to do that again. With trauma, I describe it as can be both physical or emotional, but it's always something that's too big for the comprehension of the system for it to process. So it goes into shock, as it, you can faint or become like a shock can create paralysis because your nervous system walls off the event, kind of like a hard drive on the computer sections off information that it can't process or it perceives as being dangerous to the operating system. And so the more primitive reptilian and survival functions tend to come to the forefront and automatically carry on, and the higher functions of the brain will shut down. Next thing is bonding, which is a issue of mammals and birds in that we need to get close and be under the protection and training of someone older and someone who we consider safe. For this allows us to pass on behavior and knowledge of what to do or what things are dangerous in the environment. So we learn how to survive in a more complex and adaptable manner than would be available for reptiles. So the longer the development process of the young in a species, the longer and more important it is that we have bonding and protection from within the group.
Yes.
Now, when bonding becomes disrupted, of course, then we can't trust group. We can't bond or get close, and then we tend to isolate and shut down our emotional openness. So we become emotionally closed for protection. This is really important, you know, in young people in terms of their environment. So the next thing is abandonment. And this is something that was described to me by one of my teachers as being hardwired as a survival issue in mammals and humans. Because if we get separated from the protection, let's say, of our mother or adult, an instant alarm signal goes off in the nervous system. So the infant usually starts making a noise, crying out. If it's a bird, they start cheeping and making loud noises. And the mother starts to creates a frantic kind of alarm system search, trying to connect back to the little one. Mm-hmm. But the other thing is, if you keep making a big fuss and a lot of noise and things, you'll attract attention, but sometimes it's from a predator. So then the system has to quiet down, and it goes into a kind of a withdrawal pattern again, which in later life, when you go into these withdrawal patterns, they look like a depression, because everything quiets down and the system goes into, again, a bit of a shell. So these imprinted memories store in our body and our brain circuits, and they can come out later in life, or if something similar triggers release of these memories, kind of like a Pandora's box, things open up. And so early childhood environment is very important as to how we as an individual will respond to difficulties, injury and trauma, setbacks, things like that in our future.
Very important. It was illustrated in that classic mesh versus wire monkey test, where the little monkeys went for the pseudo mom, even though there was discomfort in that pseudo mom mock makeup, yeah. and versus comfort. So, wow, yeah. Is that important?
That was one of the really significant things when I studied psychology. Yeah, that the wire monkey versus the terrytail monkey versus the warm live monkey mother. And yeah, what we saw was that the ability to play and respond to the environment versus going into a clinging, fearful, can't let go kind of a pattern was demonstrated. The terrytail mother monkey and the real warm-bodied monkey had similar effects on the child. But the wire, cold, distant type without the bonding, nurturing aspects, big difference.
Mm. Shows how important it is. Thank you so much. I am Eva Marienchild with Dr. Tim Brown, and after the break, we will talk more about pain, injury, and trauma, and how the body tries to heal. We'll be right back.
More natural therapies with Dr. Tim Brown after these short messages.
Hillcrest Bakery and Deli presents Old Time Radio on the specialty channel on localwebradio.fm. Hillcrest Bakery and Deli, serving the Semiahmoo Peninsula for over 40 years with custom cakes, deli platters, and a wide selection of fresh baked breads. Hillcrest Bakery and Deli on the corner of Thrift and Johnston, where everything is lovingly made from scratch. Call Hillcrest Bakery and Deli today at 604-531-1750. That's 604-531-1750. And visit them online at hillcrestbakeryanddeli.ca.
If you're struggling with a dental or oral health issue, be sure to catch the Healthy Smiles Oral Health Show with Dr. Norm Eckert on the Health Channel on localwebradio.fm.
Shopping for the lowest mortgage rate? Looking to refinance?
Catch the Mortgage Newscast with Jared Dreyer
on the Business Channel
on localwebradio.fm.
It's time now for more Natural Therapies with Dr. Tim Brown.
All right, we're back with Dr. Tim Brown. And how does the body try to heal from these issues?
Well, Eva, it basically tries to heal through a series of processes. So on the physical level, we go through kind of an inflammation. The transport systems start moving things to bring things and remove things from traumatized areas. There's what we call consolidation and repair. So there's a reconstruction or remodeling that occurs so that you have to have scaffolding and support structures to restore the integrity of the tissues. So we know we got to have blood supply and nerve function to service and maintain our tissues while they're active. And you have to have what I call repair factors. And these repair factors include things like enzymes, minerals, vitamins, oxygen, blood, nerve supply, and then cellular communication, or you need the blueprint for how to repair. We kind of touched on this a few sessions ago, and we talked about the blueprints for the human body and how you have to use repair materials that fit the blueprints, but you also need the proper blueprint. And what I've learned is that these blueprints are really the kind of thing that's supplied via homeopathic remedies, which contain the energy blueprints for repair factors.
Mm-hmm.
So these are like instructions in a box of components for how to assemble the components into the finished structure and what it should look like.
Exactly. The currency for the coin. Absolutely.
Right. And then sometimes through things like viral infections or major traumas or radiation or other things, these blueprints can get altered or parts can go missing, or the communication system can lose some of the areas that it needs to communicate from through all parts of the body, or what I call integration.
Mm-hmm. Now, what happens if all these factors are not available?
Well, if they're not available, either something's missing or something's interfering with the process, the body attempts to patch itself with the best available means at its disposal. So this could involve creating scar tissues or fibrosis or slowing down or inhibiting or walling off a function.
Mm-hmm.
It's similar to what a computer would try to do if it had a glitch, let's say, in the hard drive, or the operating system sees some bad information, then it tries to wall it off and segment it so that there's less damage to the overall system.
Mm-hmm.
So the attempt to repair may also lead to abnormal signals generating from improperly repaired tissue.
Mm-hmm.
The signals can be at the wrong time, so the timing is wrong, or the reason for the activation is altered so that you get an abnormal function ensuing.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're going to talk a little bit more about this in another session when we go into some of the regeneration treatments and that sort of thing and why they're needed. But the tissue can also have emotional scarring when there's strong emotional imprint or emotional connections with many of the things that we do. There are these connections can run to or from the emotional part or the limbic system in our brains. And sometimes you get emotional scarring, or with a condition, you have to also address the imprints that come from the emotional section in order to fully restore normal function in the tissues again.
How wonderfully we are made. So how does that signaling system work in our bodies?
Well, our brain and nervous system work somewhat like a mass transport system. Let's say in our area, we call it SkyTrain, or somewhere it's subway systems and buses and things. Mm-hmm. So in our SkyTrain system here, we have a central line that has various stations or hubs that connect to one another, and information travels quickly up and down the line, back and forth, as long as everything's functioning normally. Mm-hmm. Now, if there's a disruption in one of the stations, the whole system backs up. The commuters get frustrated, angry, they start complaining. Information from the outlying areas or the peripheral system also backs up because the central system can't quickly process the amount of traffic or information that's going through it. So people generally remember where the problem areas are, and then they try to avoid using that system where there's problems. And this is exactly what happens in our bodies, is it tries to avoid the problematic areas, the congested areas. But the problem is, of course, when we're in a high-paced activity and things start shutting down, then we run into major problems. And the last part of this is in the Chinese systems and the indigenous cultures from places I've studied like Hawaii, Korea, the Indian, North American Indian cultures, there's things like acupuncture meridians and nerve energy centers or nerve plexi, which they call chakras in the old literature. But these areas store memories as suppressed information or symptom imprint patterns. Mm-hmm. And when the system fragments in order to survive, which is a term I called disintegration, mm-hmm. The North American Indians would call it that you lost some of your spirit. Mm-hmm. And in order to heal, you have to call your spirit back, or the fragmented part of self has to reintegrate back into the whole self, or back into the group system. Now, the treatment methods for using this in the traditional way are things like acupuncture, various types of spiritual practices, meditation in the East, and some of the disciplines. And then in the Western world, homeopathy and other types of integrative healing systems have developed. So it's part of our training in the broad scope of naturopathic medicine. And if we look throughout the history of the world, mankind and all the different cultures, we see various ways that these healing traditions help us to reintegrate it from trauma, from pain, from imprints.
That's why they call naturopathic global medicine. And that's a wonderful analogy, that commuter visual. Thank you for that. Dr. Brown, do you have any final thoughts that you'd like to share with us?
Yes, I'd like to say that when the body or self is injured, there are areas that can be left with incomplete or improper healing response. These often end up being pain generators. And we don't need to suffer needlessly from these pain generators, because much has been learned about how to treat them using a combination of assessment and treatment methods that integrated medicine doctors, such as naturopathic physicians and others have a much better knowledge now of how to treat these things. And when we go into our next topic, which I'd like to talk about chronic pain, and we talk about new understanding and treatment methods for basically understanding and dealing with chronic pain.
Thank you for that valuable information. Dr. Brown, thank you for all of this information. As always, it's valuable. And it's a glimpse into how we are affected by pain, injury, and trauma, and how our very complicated bodies work to treat this issue. I look forward to speaking with you again next week. I'm sure our audience does too. If you, the audience, can think of someone who might benefit from what we have talked about today, please go ahead, share this podcast with them. They'll thank you so much for it. And you can reach Dr. Timothy Brown by telephone at 604-538-3017. Or you can visit the staff online at www.oceanparkhealth.com. Dr. Brown, thanks so much, and speak to you next time.
Thank you. Have a good day.
You've been listening to The Natural Therapy Show with Dr. Tim Brown, architect and creator of Ocean Park Natural Therapies. If you feel that you are a few steps farther down the health ladder than you should be, the naturopathic doctors at Ocean Park Natural Therapies want you to know that you can be helped. For more information and to book your appointment, call 604-538-3017. That's 604-538-3017. And visit them online at www.oceanparkhealth.com.
On your computer, on your smartphone, on your Wi-Fi radio, we're localwebradio.fm.
This episode is a production of Jam Media. For information on hosting your own web radio show, visit jammedia.com. That's www.jambmedia.com.
The opinions expressed by our guest and host on localwebradio.fm do not necessarily reflect the views of Jam Media or its owners. No expressed or implied opinions of any product or service should be considered an endorsement or recommendation of any kind by Jam Media or its owners.